Control D, duplicate it. So see, there's a second horn there. And all you do is you go over here to the transform and you turn that into a negative one, hit enter. That's gonna duplicate it perfectly. And then what you wanna do is freeze the model and freeze the I have a shortcut for it over here, but I'm trying to find it for you down here. Freeze all transforms, so that it becomes a 1 again instead of a negative 1. Okay. And if you want to check on the normals, you just go to the little eye tool over here. And you turn on normals, and make sure that those guys are pointing out, and not inside. If they're pointing inside, that means your normals, your faces are turned. If they are turned, then you just right-click the face and you invert the polygons. So see, now those polygons are gonna be... They see their normals are pointing in. That means that they won't show up in game. Normals gotta be out. There we go. You're welcome, Prime. Change the track a little bit. Totally, Natalie. It's Atlas Plug, and yeah, the Dota guys, the Dota Cinema guys use it a lot. That's probably why it reminds you of it. Lasso. Oh, it's a TGA, so it won't actually show me the image. Duh. What? Seriously? You don't like TGAs? God damn. Alright, who was it that came up with the idea of putting a Dota logo on here? To clean that up a little bit. You meanie, it was you. Alright, man. So, check this out. We're gonna clean this up and just stamp it on there and then clean, dig into it a little bit with a brush. Gonna do a smart blur. And that'll get rid of a lot of this little detail that's getting actually sculpted. We don't want it. Also want to clean up. All of these darks. That should be better. Actually, if we want to be really clean about it, I don't know, we grab a 50% gray. We brush that into the outsides at 100%. Save us some cleanup time. And we can darken the rest a little bit more too. Okay, let's try that. Reimport this guy. Should be cleaner now. Yeah, way cleaner. Where should we put this logo? We'll get sued over it. Man, this is for Dota. Just in this middle guy. Hey, Sagacious. Yeah, I have the bloodstained bridges for Pudge, the pants, and I have the tools of the Mad Harvester in. Frosty, you thinking on the rib over here? Whoa, wrong spot. Something like that. Yeah, you're right, it is the biggest. Did I even put that in the right side up? I didn't. It's freaking mirrored right now. Shit. Well, I guess if it is mirrored, it's gonna be backwards anyways. So the other side is gonna be right. we want a little bit to be on top. But maybe we want to do it the other way. This is the right way. Yeah, as much as I can. Tried to make it a little bit part of the design. Yeah, man, there you go. You can tell them that was your idea right there. Wow, Hopefully it shows up. I think it should. We'll see. Alright, I think we're this is good to go. A lot of that detail we'll just have to bring out in the texture, but it'll give us a good starting point even if it doesn't show up too much in the normal map. Which I fear most of it won't, just the really big spots. And we'll have the coin over here. That was Natalie's call. One coin. One drink. There it is. Alright. Save this. And we are gonna decimate this bad boy. Because it's like freaking over 10 million polys, I'm sure. So we're gonna pre-process current, okay. And it'll take a few seconds. Should be alright though. Still analyzing it, man. Yeah, that's a lot of polygons. Polygons. I should have deleted this guy sitting over here. Because they were gonna be mirrored. But again, at the beginning we didn't think we're gonna zBrush any of this. It's taking longer than expected. Good eye, Natalie. That logo was totally backwards. I only saw it afterwards. The other side won't be, well, it will be flipped, but it won't be upside down, because I had it backwards and upside down before. Yep, yep. Wow. I think I might use the horse emblem from his chest, or from his belly, that Val is gonna be creating, and I'll just paste that onto the coin in Photoshop as a normal map. Actually no, I won't be able to, that's gonna be way too detailed, I have to make something way simpler. Let's make it a stream thing. You guys come up with something for the coin, I will put it on there. As long as I agree with it. But you guys come up with something cool. Something, I mean, maybe like the shape of a horse, like the outline a little bit, maybe a little more stylized or something like that. I don't know, run off with that idea. Oh wow, okay, are we done here? Doing stuff, thinking. Come on, zBrush. No, still thinking? Okay, here we go. So this is... There's 10, almost 11 million polygons. Damn it, Natalie, I knew you were gonna say snowflake. I knew it. I didn't want to say anything just in case you didn't say snowflake, but there it is. God damn it. Decimate. Okay, let's see here. Gotta make this 350,000 polygons and see if that looks okay. Alright, that's 300,000 polygons now. Looks almost identical to the 10 million polygon mesh we had before. Alright, we're gonna export this. I know now, don't worry. How about a simplistic dragon? Yeah, I mean, we could go with the Chinese. There we go. We're gonna go ahead and grab these guys and this guys and this guys. And I'm gonna delete them. We don't need your polys. I'm gonna grab this guys. We're only gonna need this area for baking shadow, so I'm gonna go do this. Keep. Grab you, freeze, and get out of the way. Ah! Damn it. Freeze you. Grab you guys. Freeze you. Move you out of the way. Okay. There we go. And we don't need you. You. Okay. Oh, wait. Don't need you. Okay. You guys. Duplicate you and get the fuck out. I think I should bake this guy separately from the top guys. Yeah. Oh, really? You guys and delete. The digital frontier. One day. I got it. I can probably make these guys together. These guys might be a pain in the butt, but separate Yeah, dragon might work. And the face actually kind of looks like a horse too. I don't know if you guys remember the Mortal Kombat logo, but looks like a horse and a dragon at the same time. Too big together with these guys. Maybe I can even mirror this little strap over here. I'll need a top though. The grid. Save us some UV space. Well, I think before we split that, we have to figure out our UVs. I'm gonna leave that how it is for now. Give this guy a little bit a better color. Okay. Take off selection from our high poly, so we never select the high poly. Way easy to select everything now. Jeez, that's a lot of stuff to fit into a UV map, you guys. I'd even mirror these two sides of this hair. That would be smart. Might be tougher than the head to fit into 256. The good thing about this is that it's not right in your face in the avatar view, so the smaller resolution will be okay. Because there's a lot more surface to cover. So these guys are gonna be mirrored. Okay, not you guys. Thing. And we know that this is going to be mirrored. And actually, let's move this guy out of our mirroring rig. And we're going to duplicate it and throw it on the left side. And we're going to merge these guys. Check this out. We're gonna save polygons here. We're gonna delete these. Bam. Oh, we saved those quadros. About 15 polygons there. And the middle won't be mirrored. So it'll help us out both in the symmetry look and save us some polygons. Now, let's make this translucent so we can see what the hell we're doing. And match this a little bit better with our scene. This is gonna be mirrored anyways. And let's hide our head too. There we go. Yeah. And we have to match this. This is gonna be tricky. I have to see what the left side looks like. Oh no. You should be in the low poly. Oh. Hmm. Okay, I know how. We'll fit the right side first, and then worry about the other side after. We just have to pick really good spots for the mirror areas to go on. What about this side after? Put it right in the corner so our texturing becomes way easier. That's actually a good spot right there. Oh, whoa, that's not. I wanna go to the edge. We should have more polygons there. But another little loop right there, that'd be nice. What can I do though? Other guys seem to be alright. These guys look good. Oh, it is really Shrek. It's normal, that happens to everybody. How about a Chinese coin? We used Google to find this. Let's take a look. And we'll put it onto my Firefox so everybody can see it. Ooh. Natalie for the win. I actually like that quite a lot. Maybe more in a bronze color, but I like the square. That the square is very Chinese. Love it. You know what, Natalie? We are gonna use it. Good job, good find. Alright, now that I have this set, a really simple way to get this other edge fitting perfectly across here. I'm gonna just mirror it on the X. And I'm gonna delete these guys. And then I grab these guys. And all I need to do is snap them. And I know that that's exactly the other side mirrored. Oh wow, I hit that one right on. And I can just delete that. And there we go. Bam! Yeah. Perfect. What I should do though is have the other high poly in there just in case some of the polys can I eat up into there, see into that empty space there. We want to have those other polys on there, so let's grab those. And we're gonna keep freeze. Throw over there, and then grab these guys, delete those, grab these guys, grab these guys, grab, merge. Zeros, delete. And we'll give it our black texture again. There we go. And if we want to get all fancy with it, we can do, F8, F7. Ah, it doesn't like the back-facing stuff. Nope, well, that didn't work. better than nothing. All we need is the little insides there anyways. Actually, there's a way to do this. If I can remember what my key is. It's one of these, I swear. There it is. Slice. Home slice. There we go. Delete plugins is what I need, so it speeds up our bake time. Sweet. Alright, let's make this coin a little bit bigger. Actually, maybe we can make it big enough so that it goes into one of these guys. Into the sides. And it goes into the center of the coin. You know what I mean? This will take some of my cunning. No! All of my cunning. Those are not my sub smooth stuff. I find my sub smooth. Did I put in my tools? Oh, up here. Up here. There they are. Find where the center is. In here somewhere. Oh, thanks, Natalie. It's I think once we finish, it's gonna look really, really good. Let's see our coin. How big do we want that square to be? So it's about... It's cut off in thirds, it looks like. So the inside should be a third of the rest of the sides there. So if we do a third... Actually work out quite okay. that side is way longer. Morta, welcome to the live workshop. And everybody else that's been here, welcome. If you're new to the stream, make sure you hit that follow button for us. And also make sure you check out liveworkshop.com. We have all our past broadcasts, tutorials, videos, and forums there. If you want to have, if you want some feedback on your models, or you're stuck somewhere with a program, you can post in the forums, and we'll make sure to help you guys out. We have all the past broadcasts from texturing to zBrushing to illustration, beauty renders, rigging, all sorts of goodies, guys. Go check that out. Edges. Alright, let's do it with percussion on it. Blood for the blood god. Yeah, man, this is for Juggernaut. Check it out. Ah, where's our head? Where the hell did our head go? You should be in the avatar section. Come on, man. We're right now grabbing all the detail and adding a coin to the already zBrush part for the shoulders and all that. I actually really like how that coin is gonna get broken up with the longer straps. Maybe making these traps thicker would be good too. I think this one we can do the zBrush. We have more edge loops, of course. And we don't have to worry about the back, I guess. Let's see, what can I do with this coin? Maybe the easiest way to bring this into... Because this got a lot of darks in it, which is gonna take into a zBrush bump, so I can make an alpha straight out of this. I have to paint part of it. So let's paint it. Be fun. My mid, right? There we go. Yeah, man, Tron soundtrack is the shit.
frontier. I tried to picture clusters of information as they moved through the computer. What did they look like? Ships, motorcycles, were the circuits like freeways? I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day, I got in.
Okay guys, I'm gonna take a 2 minute break, 3 minute break or so. I have a friend from Italy that just had a kid and he wants to Skype me for a minute, so I'm just gonna say hello and we'll come back to making this mask for for this coin for zBrush, and then we'll apply it on zBrush. It's gonna be really cool, guys, so hang tight, we'll be right back. Alright guys, we're back. Sorry about that. That took way longer. I was totally trying to get off the call, but good lord. Drunk people, man. Drunk people. Well, thanks for staying on, guys, and waiting for me. Hello, Smex Dota. How are you, man? Welcome to the Live Workshop. We are making a coin for this zBrush armor piece that we're making for Juggernaut for the Chinese New Year event. And it's gonna go right here on the last tile, thanks to Natalie. And we also got a little Dota insignia over here, thanks to Times. Some contributions from the stream. Awesome. Yeah, yeah, let's keep going, let's keep going. Alright, we're making a mask in Photoshop. So what I'm doing right now, the whites are gonna be pulled out, and the grays are gonna stay where they are, and the black's gonna be pushed in when I make this mask for zBrush. So all the indents I have to make black, etc, etc, etc. Well, let's see here. Let's just do all the whites first, which is the guys that are sticking out. So we can do this, select those guys, and then do another. Fill this guy in and scale down. There we go. Then we select this guy's and unselect this guy's. Nope. There we go. And then flip. And then fill in with white, move it down, and merge it down, and we get that same soft, that blur that we have in there, which is actually an inner glow that I did without the screen pass on it. It's gonna make that bump map transition really nice instead of being super stiff. So that's why that's there, if any of you guys are wondering. Sorry, I'm gonna send that out now that we're actually working again after that Skype call. Alright, now let's do this Chinese letters. Actually, I don't think that's part of the... Is that part of the... I don't think it is. I think we'll make two levels. One that's a little bit beveled and then the other one. I think that'll be better for us. Whoops. Oh, can't really see this one here. I think it goes over here. It's really used in there. We can do with the cone underneath, turn that into a grayscale and filter this into a soft smooth. Get rid of all that crazy noise. Well, maybe not so much. A little bit so it goes more into our gray. Okay, now our black layer, this one which I didn't name, we're gonna give it an outer glow. Nope, not drop shadow. Outer glow with a normal and a black, and then just scale the size up a little. Whoa. Little bit of a blur there. That'll make our transition to normal on the normal map a little bit smoother. There we go. Okay. Oh, you think it had a thing on top up here? Which part are you talking about, man? I think, didn't I get most of that, those letters, but okay? In Chinese, it means forever? Prosperous? Of manners. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, all those things seem okay. I mean, as long as it doesn't say, like, two egg rolls or anything, we'll be okay. See, missing like a little thing right here. No, it doesn't have it though. It's this is gonna be skilled really small, guys. I mean, I think we're good. If anything, I need to smooth out some of these guys here. The fact that we worked off that coin into this shape that is really, really close, it's gonna help us out when we start doing the texture, because we'll have a really good place to start for the color map. We'll just have to clean it up, of course, quite a bit, but we'll have a really good color for all the oxidation and everything like that. All of those little details in the color will be great. Alright, it looks pretty good. Okay, gold coin, we have it. Now we have to bring in the coin art itself from here. Maybe go bigger, I think. And we're gonna merge this guy and export him as well. But not with the coin, as separate objects, I think. Someone complains. Yeah, actually, if someone complains, I'll blame Natalie, since it was her fault. Hello, Dota 2 Failure. Welcome to Lab Workshop. Let's bring that coin in here. Coin. There she is. And so these traps that are in here right now are obsolete. We're gonna bring the new ones in. And they're gonna overlap the old ones, but that's okay. We don't care about that stuff right now. And they're there. Oh, that's subdivided a little bit different than in Softimage. That's okay. We're just worried about the coin more than anything. We can move those around in Softimage later. Let's see if we can do this stamp. That'd be tricky. So it doesn't look like we have a complete circle here the way that it just got subdivided by zBrush. Shit. Alright, well, let's try anyway. We did a good job with the mask, you guys. Of course, we gotta do this so it's not upside down. Which one's on top? I don't even... was this right? No. This is flipped, isn't it? Damn it, which way is it supposed to be facing? Oh, hang on. Palacios, thank you. Let's see. Okay, no, this is right. Alright, I thought I had it. I just have to find the middle now. A little bit off center, so let's go from here. That got quite a bit of relief on it. Oh, all right, let's bring that down to half. 23. Yeah, there's a delay because of Twitch. Dear. All right. That's right about there. About right. I can probably even push this a bit more actually. So let's try something like 29 or so. Let's do a quick one. Alright, I think this one's the winner. Yeah. All right. Now we just have to move this coin out of the way. Actually, let's save this first. And let's export this piece. That's a coin. Okay, that's fine. Port. Oh, no. HP coin. There we go. And we'll bring it in here now. We can get rid of this coin, actually. It's 140,000 polygons. Whew. All right, now let's move it down a little bit. Is it proof? Anyone up? Come on, proof, lay down. Boy. Hey Palacios, I'm gonna get a bring it down. This is just for the bake. So when I do, I already did the low poly. Let me grab the low poly. All that detail is gonna bake down into this many polygons in here. But all this is gonna show up with normal maps and with a texture file. But we'll be all right. Now let's fix this. I don't know about you guys, but I could listen to this track all day long. If you guys get sick of it, we can change it. Take a boat. You got a coin, you guys. Now, maybe we can do a different color. Like more of like the coin color, perhaps? No. Maybe more like the bronze. But with highlights and all that fun jazz. I won't be able to get the color in one color, so keep it like this for now. It was a better color before, wasn't it? Make something from nothing. Yeah, well, all you do here in Softimage, you go to a primitive and you can bring in, you can start with a cylinder, a disc, a grid, a sphere. So a cube is usually a pretty good spot to start with. So there's your cube. You can add slices to it in any direction you would like. And the same with the sphere, you can make a sphere and add more polygons to it, etc. Or just with the grid, a bunch of squares. And you can, if you have a, you know, if you have one square, you can just extrapolate from it. Oops. I'll start making maybe the shape of like the shoulder or something. I keep building from there. Right? There we go, we're getting a little better shape here. And this middle part in here is gonna get knocked out. It's gonna be black, so it'll look better once we're done with it. Just imagine. What a cheat. What a cheater. We had our low poly. Ah, where are you not? Be? I guess our old high poly. Get on your lair. How come I have to switch between zBrush and Softimage? Softimage is not a high polygon sculpting program. zBrush is. In zBrush you can sculpt millions of polygons with brushes and all the specialized stuff. Softimage is more for making your low and mid polygon models and rendering and animating and rigging and all these other complex things, and it's more universal. zBrush is more just like, you know, make your high poly stuff pretty much. And you can do painting and all these other things, but yeah. Mostly for sculpting high poly stuff. Hey Regazor, we have we do have a sword. My buddy Val is the one making the sword. Where is it? There it is. So this is the sword we have. I believe we have a there's a high polygon model for it with zBrush and a whole bunch of detail on it. But this is the in-game mesh for it. And he's gonna have a sheet in the to go with this with the sword. It's gonna look really cool. It's actually scaled up a bit too big right now, actually. Be more like this or something. But still, bigger than his default sword for sure. It'll look really cool. Thanks, Nat. Yeah, I think the coin came out great. Now we just have to make that polygon bigger than the other guy so that we can render that much detail of the coin on there. Or as much as possible, anyways. I mean, if I could, I'd make that coin bigger, even bigger than right now. But it is reaching kind of like the edge already. Will I make items when Dota 3 comes out? Man, well that's gonna take forever. I think Dota 2 is gonna be around for a long time. And there's a lot of heroes to make items for, so... Alright, let's see what we're doing. Alright, I think we got all the high poly stuff really done here, guys. Stuff looks awesome. I guess we have to unwrap this bad boy now. Dota 2 is not even out of beta. well, I guess it's, yeah, you're right, it's, I guess technically open, the beta's open for everybody, but it's still beta, I guess, for some reason. Let's unselect that, so we can select our stuff, and we're gonna hit the head now. And the body, actually, this guy's stuff, and go on to... You too. Clean up our palette a little bit here. Okay. Here's all the stuff we need to unwrap. Can we fit it all into 256 by 256? Nope. We cannot. Well, let's unwrap it all and see how much we can fit. And we'll compare it to the UVs on the head and see how much smaller we actually are. Hello, Limes. Welcome, dude. Map time. You guys want me to change the soundtrack to something else? Or are you guys digging Tron? Thank you. These guys are gonna be mirrored as well. I'm gonna duplicate the one side, so just to make sure we're still in polycam budget before I start unwrapping, just to make sure. All these guys that are kinda, well, I'm gonna just make them red. No, I can't make them. These guys will be mirrors. So if we go ahead and select all these guys. Is this even showing up on here? There we go. We are at 778 polygons. 790 polygons. What's going on here? How come we're under budget? I mean, it's a good thing, but we have 10 polygons that disappeared from somewhere. Was it the line running down the middle, maybe? I thought I counted that before. So we have 10 polygons, I can probably add a little bit of detail with a coin or something. Yeah, I don't see anything missing, that's freaking awesome. 10 polygons. So many windows open. Oh, some of these. Let's see if we can add some detail to that coin. I mean, 10 polygons, not gonna be a lot. Like, maybe the straps and that's about it. We're falling off the edge already a little. More than 10 polygons. Hello, Polyhedron. Welcome to the stream, man. We're making some Juggernaut set for the Chinese New Year Dota event. Oh, in here, you can modify your UI for Softimage. You go to, where are we? Display, I think. It's been a while. Layouts. No, is it layouts? Yeah. And you can create a new blank layout, for single or dual screen, or you can create a new layout from compositing. There's a bunch of like presets down here, and once you're in that, into that selection view, it's kind of tricky. You'll have to experiment with it for a bit, because it's kind of hard to even exit out of the thing. You have to go back into the menu and tell it to exit. It won't be anywhere on the screen, so heads up for that. But once you're in that menu, you can start splitting windows within windows and telling what window you want that to be. So the reason I put this little window over here is if I'm like in shaded mode over here, and I want to grab all the vertices, but I don't want to go into wireframe mode, select all the vertices, and then come back out to shaded mode, I can just stay in shaded mode and go into vertice mode, and this little window I can just go whoop and select all the ones that I want without having to change that shading mode on the big screen. So that's a little awesome thing as Softimage has. Alright, let's see, what can we do with 10 polygons, you guys? Was that Natalie, your sword, huh? Oh, I guess you're right, Darpo, I guess we are officially out of beta, but all the files still say beta. I don't know, well, they can't change those folders now, that'll be a fucking nightmare. Oh, you're talking about Europe. Yeah. Unlimited power. Star Wars reference for you guys. Anybody got that? Bonus points. What do we do with this coin? It's driving me crazy. I have an idea. This is 36 polygons. But let me see if I can do some magic with this. Six polygons. There's no way I can do it in 10. Like, maybe if I did it into an alpha mask, and it'd be like a floating coin. But then the resolution would be able to be bigger at that point, which is good. Hmm. 12 polygons. Yeah, I mean, to me, the game has been official for a long time. Not really a beta anymore. I think beta is just because not everybody could download it before. You know, like at will. They had to be put on that waiting list and everything. But yeah, it's been released.